Hello dear students. So students, as you all know that soon you are going to have your final exam. So start preparing for it, as this time you have to give your exams in your hard copies. Okay, so watch the videos properly, go through each and every question of your exercise. Okay, so let's get started. Class 5, we are starting revision of your chapter number 3, that is your factors and multiples. Okay, so in this chapter you must study that what are your prime numbers, composite numbers, natural numbers, even, odd, integers, what are your co-prime numbers, twin prime numbers, and how to find the prime factorization. These topics are very important. You should know that what are prime numbers, composite number, natural number, even number, odd number, integers, co-prime number, twin prime number, and prime factorization. How to find out the prime factorization. I have explained you all this in my previous videos. So you can go and watch the previous videos for knowing them. Okay. So first topic is your HCF. In this chapter, you are having that how to find your HCF, how to find the LCM. So finding the HCF is very important. HCF means highest common factor. So first you have to find the common factors. Now what are the factors? Factors means the number which divides the given number completely. Okay, so first you have to find the common factor of the two number, and then you have to find the highest among them. So for finding the HCF, you are having two method. One is your prime factorization method, in which you do the prime factors of the given number, and second is your long division method. In this, practice both the methods, but pay attention towards the long division method. Okay, it is very important. Next is your LCM. LCM means least common multiple. And what are your multiples? Multiples you can find by multiplying the given number with any other counting number. By multiplying, suppose we have to find the multiple of 3. So for finding the multiple of 3, you can multiply 3 with 1, then with 2, then 3, and with so on. Okay. So again, for finding the LCM, we are having two methods. First is your prime factorization method, in which you do the prime factors. And second is your long division method. Both the methods are very important. You have to practice both the methods, because in this chapter, these two are very important. Third is your relationship between the HCF and LCM. In your question paper, definitely there will be one question based on this relation. That is HCF into LCM is equals to first number multiplied by second number. You have to use this formula, and there will be definitely one question based on this formula. In these questions, you will be given 3 terms I have been giving you, and you have to find the fourth one. Okay, so practice questions based on this formula. You have at least practice 2, 2, 3, 3 questions of them. Okay, class 5, next is your geometry. Okay, in geometry you should study that what is a line segment, and a ray. Okay, this I have explained you, so you have to go through it, that what is a line segment and ray. And again, you are having this kind of figure, and you should know how to recognize a line segment or a ray in these kinds of figure. So I have drawn a figure over here, and your questions come like OA is R. Now where is OA? This is O and this is A. Now if you draw OA, then it will be look like this. This is your O and this is your A. Now you can see OA is a ray. So you will write OA is a ray. Now come to your HC. This is your H and this one is your C. Again, if you draw HC, it will be look like this. Okay, H, we are having a dot, and at C, I have made an arrow. So again, HC is a ray. Next is your AB. Now come to your AB. AB is drawn like this, and it is having arrow on both the side. If it is having arrow on both the side, then it indicates that AB is a line. Okay, and next is your OB. Now this is your O, and this is your B. Again, if you draw OB, then it indicates like a ray. So this is your ray. Now if I ask that what is O, then O is your point. Okay, now come to this DE. Okay, DE. If you draw DE, then it should be like this. Both and, I'm having ands on both the sides. So DE is a line segment. Okay, these kind of questions can come in which I have given you a figure and you have to I have asked you that what is OA or HC, and you have to answer that whether they are ray, line or line segment. Okay, which is your angle. So what is an angle? When two ray have meet at a point, then they form an angle. Okay, now I have drawn an angle over here. Now first question is how you will name it. Okay, so you can name it by using the points on the angle. First, this is your A, B and C. This is your angle. So you will write angle. This is the symbol of angle. Angle A, B, C, or you can write angle C, B, A. The only thing which you have to keep in mind is that this vertex should be written in middle. What is your vertex? Vertex is here your B. Okay, so whenever you are naming an angle, you have to keep in mind that the vertex should be written in middle. Now, if I told you that what are the two arms or two sides of this angle, so the sides are B, C and B, A. So your sides will be B, C and B, A. Clear? Now, I told you that what is an exterior and interior of an angle. Okay, so here, till here, the points which lies between this boundary is known as to be interior of an angle, and the points which lie outside the boundary is known as your exterior. So the points in the interior are M and N. You can see that M and N is lying between there in the interior of angle ABC. So you will write M and N. Now the points in the exterior will be, what are the points which lie in the exterior? You can see this is the boundary. What are the points? So here is only one point, that is Q. So Q lies in the exterior of angle ABC. Now you can see that R and P are lying on angle ABC. So if they ask that what are the points which lie on angle ABC, so that are your R and P.